There is a nice verse of Billamangal Thakur. He lived for 700 years in Vrindavan, and became a great devotee of Krishna. In the beginning, he was an impersonalist. His life is very nice. It is better to cite his life. He was a South Indian Brahmin, a very rich man, and very much sensuous. He kept one prostitute. He was so much, devoted to the prostitute that he was performing his father's death ceremony, and he was asking the priest, please haste, please make haste, I have to go. My prostitute's house. So he was a very rich man, a priestly anyway, he finished that business. Then there was ceremony, he took very nice foodstuff in a bag and he was going to that prostitute's house. But when he came out of his home, it was raining torrently. So he never cared for that raining. He went to the riverside. Oh, there was no boat, and it was the river was waving. The waves were very furious. And he thought, how can I go the other side? He was daily going to the other side of the river. Then, he crossed over by swimming. Then the prostitute thought, it is today raining, and he may not come. So he blocked the door and went to sleep. And when he came to the house, he saw the door is blocked, and it was raining still. So how can I go? So he crossed over the wall by catching one snake. Just see how much intensely he was attached, and went to the prostitute, and he was astonished. Well, Billamangal, his name was Billamangal. How do they have to come here like this? Oh, he described, yes, I did this. So, the prostitute was astonished. Her name was Chintaman. So, the prostitute said, my dear Billamangal, if you have got so intense love for me, had it been for God, for Krishna, I would have been your life sublime. Let's trap him. Yes. He at once left and went back. Yes, you are right. Then he was Vrindavan. Well, he saw another beautiful woman, because he has practiced to that habit. So he was going behind, although he determined, now I am going to Vrindavan. On the way, he was again attracted by another woman. So he followed that woman. That woman belonged to a respectable family. So he came, and the woman said to him, to her husband, sir, this man is following me. Please ask, what is the idea? The husband asked, my dear sir, you appear to be a very nice gentleman, and you belong to a very aristocratic family. From your appearance, I understand. What do you want? You are following my wife. He said, yes, I am following your wife because I want to embrace her. Oh, you want to embrace? Come on, embrace. Come on, you are welcome, come on. So, the wife also, see, here is a guest. See, he wants to embrace you and kiss you. So, please decorate yourself nicely so that he may enjoy. So the wife also followed the instruction of the husband, because wife's duty is to follow the instruction. And when Billamangal came inside, before the woman, he said, "My dear mother, will you kindly give your hairpins?" "Yes." "Why?" "I have got some business." He took the hairpin and at once pierced his eye. "So this eye is my enemy." And he became blind. He became blind. Then all of them, that's all right. Now, no more I shall be disturbed. So in that blindness, he was financing austerities in Vrindavan. So by the grace of Krishna, Krishna came like a boy. "Oh, my dear sir, why you are starving? Why didn't you take some milk?" "Oh, who are you, my dear boy?" "Oh, I am a boy and this of this village. I am a cowherd boy. If you like, I can give you daily some milk." "All right, very good." So Krishna was supplying him milk. So there was friendship. He has written that bhakti is such a thing that mukti mukulita anjali sevati asmal. Mukti is nothing for me. So this is his verse. Mukti mukulita anjali sevati asmal. So we have no desire for mukti. When Krishna comes to supply milk, then what is the use of my mukti? So that's a great soul, Billamangal Thakur. It is worth to remember his name. For 700 years he lived in Vrindavan. And he has written a nice book which is called Krishna Karnamrita. That is a very authoritative book, Krishna Karnamrita. Lord Chaitanya picked up this book and he recommended all his devotees to read that, Krishna Karnamrita.